Langford and Gary's calculations. So in the last class we discussed about SN1 reactions. SN reactions are two types: nuclear substitution reactions, SN1 reactions, and SN1 reactions and SN2 reactions. But here we decrease the sum over one is SN1 reaction is followed by dissociation mechanism, and SN2 reaction is followed by association mechanism. Here they give the different Langford and Zeri give two different of the four. I think four is A is association, D is dissociation, and IA is interchange association, and ID is interchange dissociation, and intimate mechanism. So today we discuss about what is SN1 reactions. It is followed by dissociation mechanism, whereas SN2 is followed by association mechanism, and interchange association and interchange dissociation mechanism. So the first one is dissociation mechanism, D mechanism, or anything they ask in examinations. SN1 reaction, ML6 plus L dash, Q's rise, ML5 L dash plus L. It is nothing but the incoming ligand move to the outer sphere to inner sphere, where outgoing ligand move from inner sphere to outer sphere. So this step of produce two step. First one is ML6 is used as the first step is the one mole is involved in the first step. So that's why we called as nuclear substitution reactions in unimolar. So this molecule is dissociated into two parts, ML5 and 1L. So in this reaction involves formation of intermediate with reduced coordination number. So here this 6 becomes 5, as nothing but if it is example for the 4 coordination, it becomes 3. So anything, the dissociation mechanism is favorable for the octahedral complex mostly. So this is slow and rate determining step. So because the metal bond is break, the bond between the metal and ligand is breaking is where it takes place. So that's why it takes some time. So that is we called as slow step. It is rate determining step. This reaction occurs in steps is a step in unimolecular. The second step is the reduced coordination compound. It is nothing but an intermediate is reacted with the incoming ligand. It becomes fast, the ML5 plus L dash. So here the formation takes place. Reaction of the intermediate with the incoming ligand. This is a first step. Okay. So you can calculate the rate. What is the rate of the particular reaction? So rate is equal to minus D by DT. ML6 concentration is equal to reactant concentrations plus D by DT is nothing but reduce the reactant concentration and increase the complex concentration. So that is equal to K2 into ML5 concentration L concentration. So here K2 the reactants are ML5 concentration into L concentration. So this equation, we put equation 1, we don't know the intermediate concentration ML5. We can use a steady state approximation. The steady state approximation, the concentration of a intermediate, concentration of the intermediate does not change with the time, because we take a low concentration of the reactant. So here for example, you take the reactant very low concentration, so this is reduced as ML5 plus L. So the incoming ligand, the outgoing ligand, we have very less concentration. So the reactant concentration is very low. So the removing of ligand also, the concentration is less. So hence the intermediate should be equal to zero. So all the intermediates in the particular complex, so minus D by DT, ML5 concentration is equal to zero. So we can calculate that all equilibrium constants with the reactant concentration. So here K1 into we don't bother about how can we by heart all these things. Simply you remember these two reactions. So these two reactions is enough to calculate the rates of the particular complex. So first the forward reaction K1 into ML6 concentration. Backward reaction is nothing but minus K minus 1 ML5 concentration into L concentration. Again the second step. So it is a fast reaction. So say the reactant. So again K2 into ML5 concentration into L concentration. So that is the right one here. Again equal to 0. So we write all the negative terms one side, and K1 into ML6 is the positive terms is one side. Again here we observed it, the ML5 concentration is same. So ML5 concentration we get common here. K minus 1 L concentration into K2 into L dash concentration. So again substitution in the equation 1, वी कैन कैलकुलेट K2 into ML5 concentration into L concentration. So we substitute the rate is equal to K2 into ML5 concentration L concentration. We substitute this one. Again we observed here the denominator L and L dash. So the reactant concentration is low. So this L concentration also very low. So we can neglect it. We are neglected that one and you write the we neglect. So this whole term is equal to 0. So divided by K2. L dash, so L dash will cancel, K2 cancel, so K1 is a nothing but equilibrium constant, so it is a almost proportional to, so we can write rate is proportional to ML5, so here rate is 1, so the order of the SN1 reaction is 1, so it is followed by only dissociative mechanism, whereas SN2 mechanism, so in the SN2 nothing but A mechanism, A means some examination they ask what A, discuss the A mechanism, you don't bother about that, A is nothing but association, association means addition of in single step only, ML6 plus L dash. This gives rise K1 slow reaction. Why? Because bond making also takes some time. So they have transitioned with the increasing coordination number. For example, here 6 is becomes 7. Here, for example, you take 4 coordination complexes, square planar complex becomes pentacoordinated. So association mechanism mainly observed in the square planar complexes. The rate of association mechanism is depend upon association of incoming ligand. It is observed in the second order reaction. So K2 is fast ML5 L dash concentration plus L. So in this mechanism formation of transition state with aqueous coordination number. So the minus d by dt of ML5 L concentration is equal to K1 into complex concentration into incoming ligand concentration. So this is the increasing coordination number is nothing but 6. It becomes 7. So the coordination in the complex is pentagonal bipyramidal structure. We can explain. So the based on the structure also we can explain it is a associative mechanism or dissociative mechanism. Okay. Then another example for the square planar complex of SN2 reactions. So nickel CN 4 times. So some of the reaction mechanism. We can calculate what is the rate of reaction. It is fast or slow by the isotopic stress studies. So here the carbon is isotope. It is the carbon is 12. For we don't write here carbon 12. Only isotope of carbon 14 you can write. Again, it is the carbon is incoming ligand or this what. So here we observed the association is takes place. So here the bond before bond breaking, bond making is takes place. After some time, the bond is break between the metal and normal cyanide. And again, the C14 is addition now takes place here. So this is the isotopic stress studies to recognize it is association mechanism or dissociation mechanism. The next one we discuss about IA and ID mechanism. The IA and ID mechanism, it is nothing but ID means dissociative interchange. So it is that interchange mechanism in this is simultaneously interchange between leaving group and entering group. Leaving is nothing but outgoing group, entering group is nothing but incoming group. This takes place between the transition state. A strong bond is not formed between the M and L dash at transition state. It is not possible to isolate the intermediate. Okay, so the interchange mechanism shown by reactions, generally this type of interchange mechanisms are observed in the 6 coordinate complex of D8 complexes, nickel H2O 6 times plus 2. It is more important in the CSR exams or any competitive exams. The ID dissociation interchange mechanism means, so here the word is dissociative. So dissociative is nothing but it is depend upon the leaving group. Now dissociation means the one molecule divided into two molecules. So that is what is dissociation. So in this mechanism, the dissociate of leaving group from the central metal atom is more important rather than the formation of bond between the entering group and the metal. So it is called as dissociative interchange. So generally we write ML6 plus L dash gives rise ML6 L dash. So here the leaving group first takes place, then the entering group takes place. So this intermediate is called as, so here the complex is also there, the incoming outflow is there. So this type of is called as ion pair complex or outer sphere complex. Outer sphere means, so the incoming the outgoing ligand move from inner sphere to outer sphere. So that's why called it outer sphere complex or ion pair. Ion pair means this is a complex of, this is the one molecule. So this is called as ions, ion pair complexes. Okay. The next one is IA. IA is nothing but associative interchange mechanism. So this mechanism is the interaction between incoming ligand. In the previous case, it is the interaction between the leaving group or outgoing group, where here the interaction between incoming nucleophile and metal atom. So the evidence that then we can bond between metal ion and outgoing ligand, so it is called as associative mechanism. So the evidence, the outgoing ligand bond is become weak, the incoming ligand is become strong. So here there is an interchange of a ligand between inner and next nearest coordination sphere. So but the interaction between the metal and ligand, incoming ligand L dash, is much more advanced in transition state. So it is advanced than the weakened bond. So nucleophile ki metal atom ki unna bond anadi, it is become advanced compared with the bond weakened between the metal atom and outgoing ligand. So that's why you write here like that. So ML5 and L dash, so ML6 and L dash. So the L dash is come first and L5 is in the outgoing ligand is move after that. So that's why you can write like this here. So the incoming ligand first comes into the coordination sphere, that is called as inner and next nearest coordination sphere, and leaving group is takes place. This is both are takes place in the simultaneous. So this is first takes place, after that this one. So that is the word advanced. Incoming nucleophile, the interaction between incoming nucleophile and metal ion is advanced than weakened bond between metal atom, metal ion and outgoing ligand. So this bond is become weakened. Before this bond is weakened, this incoming ligand bond is some more advanced compared to this one. So the other example I already told you, the nickel cyanide, tetracyanide nickel 2 complex, the isotope of cyanide C14, you can write this. So this is exchanging of ligands. So here the first is 5 coordinate complex, the next one is the cyanide is moved outside, the C14 isotope cyanide is become 0. So both are depend upon metal complex concentration and incoming ligand concentration. So that's why we called as order is 2, okay, 1 plus 1. Good evening. Good night.